Students, now we will talk about the second part of carbohydrate, disaccharides and polysaccharides. Disaccharides are formed when two monosaccharides are joined together, and in the process a molecule of water gets removed. Some of the examples are lactose, sucrose and many others. So, if glycosides or acetone is formed by the reaction of the anomeric carbon of the monosaccharide with the OH group of another monosaccharide, then the glycoside product is the disaccharide. Now, we can take an example. This is the monosaccharide reacting with the alcohol. We get the glycoside. As we have told this thing before also, a glycoside is formed when any monosaccharides undergo a reaction with alcohol, they give rise to glycoside. The second monosaccharides give rise to disaccharide. This is the glycosidic bond which is shown with the red mark. You can see this is the one part of monosaccharide, this is another part of the monosaccharides, and when they react together, water molecules come out with the process called dehydration reaction. And a disaccharide is formed with the glycosidic bond. So, we can categorize disaccharide by the position of the hydroxyl group of another monosaccharide by making up the glycosides. Naturally, three occurring glycosidic linkages there, 1,4, 1,6 and 1,2. So, what is 1,4 link? The anomeric carbon, we know that anomeric carbon is C1 carbon. So, anomeric carbon which is bonded to oxygen on C4 of the second monosaccharide is the 1,4 link, glycosidic link. Again, coming over to 1,6 link, that is the anomeric carbon is bonded to oxygen on the C6 of the second monosaccharide. Similarly, 1,2 will be the anomeric carbon of the two monosaccharide units bonded through an oxygen atom. So, these things must be clear that if it is a 1,4 glycosidic linkage, then C4 of one monosaccharide is linking with the anomeric carbon of that oxygen atom. If it is 1,6, then C6 of one monosaccharide is bonded with the oxygen atom of another monosaccharide. So, vice versa, such glycosidic linkage give rise to disaccharides. Now, this is the example of 1,4 glycoside. This represents a 1,4 linkage of oxygen atom of one monosaccharide and another monosaccharide. This is maltose. We will later on see about maltose. So, this is the alpha 1,4 linkage, because the position of OH group must be in the alpha position. So, it is called alpha 1,4 linkage. Stereochemistry, here we are not specifying. We can see the linkage between the C1 of one sugar subunit and C4 of the another. So, give rise to a disaccharide carbohydrate. Okay. Next we go sucrose. Now sucrose, we are telling this is a disaccharide. So sucrose is most common and a familiar disaccharide having the molecular formula of C12H22O11. Sucrose is commonly known as table sugar. It is white, odorless crystalline powder with a sweet taste. Coming on the structure, the glucose part of one aldehyde group at C1 and the fructose part had the ketone group of the carbon C2. This linkage is 1,2 group. Neither group is free. So, this is a non-reducing sugar and it does not undergo mutarotation. Just see, it is having a 1,2 linkage and neither group is free. So, since neither group is free, so it is having a 1,2 linkage, and for that reason sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Okay. Now commercially we know sucrose is obtained from sugar cane or sugar beet. It also It is also present in various concentration in most of the fruit. Upon hydrolysis, sugar gives a molecule of D-glucose and D-fructose each. Again, to be noted that sucrose has alpha D-glucopyranose ring. It is an alpha D-glucopyranose ring attached through its C1 and C2 of beta fructofuranose. Since it is having a 1-2 linkage, that's why we are telling that it is a non-reducing sugar. Now, function of sucrose is always known. It is used in syrup preparation, tablet manufacture. It is also used in the preparation of dextrin. Dextrin is also a polysaccharide which is used as a plasma substitute. Okay. Next, we are going towards lactose. Lactose is also a disaccharide and is found mainly in the milk of mammals and is called milk sugar. Upon hydrolysis, lactose will give rise to D-glucose and D-galactose. D-galactose is present as beta-galactopyranose and D-glucose as beta-D-glucopyranose. So, the lactose has beta-D-galactopyranose ring which is attached through C1 to C4 of beta-D-glucopyranose. Since it is having a 1-4 linkage, beta-beta 1-4 linkage, and it thus can act as a reducing sugar because both the original aldehyde group were on this C1 carbon and one of them is free to react. Since it is free to react, we should remember, if any of the group is free to react, this is called reducing sugar. It can reduce. But in case of sucrose, none of the groups were free. So, they act as a non-reducing sugar. The function of lactose is widely it is used in food industry. Also, it is used as a filler in many tablets. Next, we come over to maltose. The aldehyde group are at carbon 1 at each of the original glucose molecules. It is also a free aldehyde group having 1-4 linkage, so it also can act as a reducing sugar. Okay, so maltose is a disaccharide which upon hydrolysis gives 2 units of glucose. Just remember, it gives 2 units of glucose. Okay, in case of maltose, the alpha D-glucopyranose ring is joined through C1 to C4 of beta D-glucopyranose. Just give it a pause and listen. In maltose, the alpha D-glucopyranose ring is joined through its C1 to C4 of beta-D-glucopyranose ring. Thus, one group is free, one aldehyde group is free, so it acts as a reducing sugar, and since it is acting as a reducing sugar, it also undergo mutarotation. Okay, so it is commonly called malt sugar, and the function is having the converted to glucose and is used as an energy source for growing embryo in the seed. It is also very much useful in the production of alcohol. Now, what is invert sugar? This is a very important part. Even questions come from here. What is invert sugar? So, invert sugar is a mixture of 2 equal parts of glucose and fructose, which upon hydrolysis of sugar, we get this glucose and fructose. The name stemming from the fact that it rotates the plane polarized light. We called it is invert sugar. So, invert means it is inverting, it is opposite. So, since it is inverting the plane of polarized light in the opposite direction of the sucrose, it is called the inverse sugar. That is, sugar is dextrorotatory. It rotates the polarized light in a different way than that of sucrose. So, it is called inverse sugar. Now, we commonly heard about the term artificial sweeteners. So, artificial sweeteners are actually the chemicals that are much, much sweeter than sucrose. So, a small amount of this sweetener is sufficient for giving sweetness as that of sugar. So, generally the diabetic patient uses the artificial sweetener because they cannot take the actual sugar. So they have no calories, such sweetener have no calorie and have no nutrient in them. Some of the examples are sorbitol, aspartame and saccharin. These are the structures which are important. So you should know the structure. It is interesting to know that saccharin is 300 times sweeter than sucrose. Sorbitol, as we have earlier known, glucitol. Sorbitol is a polyhydroxy compound and is having sweetness nearly 60% to that of sucrose. In diabetic patient, I have told you, in as a metabolism in insulin dependent diabetic patient, they are using as a sweetening agent. So they can be used there. Aspartame is a methyl ester of aspartyl phenyl alanine. It is a methyl ester of aspartyl phenyl alanine and is 200 times sweeter than sucrose. So nowadays aspartame is widely used as a sugar free tablets also. Many people use this in their drinks, for making bakery items also saccharin and aspartame has been used. So these are artificial sweeteners. Now coming over to polysaccharides. Okay, polysaccharide consists of number of monosaccharide units joined through glycosidic linkage. So the monosaccharides unit may have maybe homopolysaccharides or heteropolysaccharides. So polysaccharides, they are also differentiated as homopolysaccharides and heteropolysaccharides. Okay, and the name polysaccharides, actually consisting of glucose unit, if polysaccharide consists many monosaccharides having the glucose unit, they are called glucan. Okay, many of them polysaccharides, this which are widely used, are starch, glucose and cellulose. Polysaccharides do not react with tolerance reagent and thus do not mutate. They don't undergo any mutarotation. Okay, next we are going towards starch. So starch is a glucose polymer and is the principal food storage carbohydrate in plants. Okay, so upon hydrolysis we get amylose, maltose, glucose if it is soluble, and insoluble part is amylopectin, maltose and isomaltose, and which give to glucose. Okay, so this is the chain. Starch in many of the food what we are eating nowadays, like root, seed, tubers of plant, for example potato, sweet potato, rice, we get starch. A content of starch can be found out. Okay, now it is glycogen. Glycogen actually is a polysaccharide that is present in the liver and muscle tissues of animals as a reverse carbohydrate. Its acid hydrolysis result in the formation of D-glucose. Okay, now glycogen resembles amylopectin in structurally. However, it is highly branched chained polymer of glucose and the branching occur at 8 to 12 glucose unit. Okay, so glycogen serve as a reverse reserve carbohydrate in our body. It is also termed as animal starch. Next is cellulose. Okay, cellulose, the pure natural source of cellulose are cotton, jute, flax, hemp, etc. It is abundant and is also naturally and commonly occurring polysaccharides. We get its major constituents are of the plant cell wall. Okay, we can see that cellulose on hydrolysis yield D-glucose and its structure is also similar to starch. But in cellulose, one thing is there, the glucose units are joined through 1,4 beta linkage. Okay, so 1,4 beta linkage is there in case of cellulose, which you can see in the figure. This is the partial structure of cellulose where we are having beta 1,4 glycosidic linkage. You need to know, okay, cellulose are extensively used for manufacturing of paper, rayon, cellulose fiber, cellophane, solvent detergent, adhesive, etc. Okay, Now we end our chapter of carbohydrate by this slide. Thank you.